Hey guys, it's Michelle, and today's video is going to be all about the JFK assassination and the different conspiracy theories that have been circulating since pretty much when it happened. A lot of people have thought that this particular assassination was very, very suspicious, and just a lot of things don't really add up, even though there was a person, Lee Harvey Oswald, who obviously did the actual shooting. Everyone knows that he did shoot bullets that day, but people still believe that maybe he had other people working with him, and also theories about what's behind Lee Harvey Oswald and why did he, like, why was he the hitman? Like, who set him up to do it? So let's just get right into the different conspiracy theories. On November 22nd, 1963, President John F. Kennedy was assassinated in Dallas, Texas. He was apparently, like I said, shot by Lee Harvey Oswald and was pronounced dead 30 minutes later at Dallas's Parkland Hospital. While everyone was very, very positive that Lee Harvey Oswald was the hitman, there are still many, many, many conspiracy theories surrounding the assassination of JFK. The first theory I want to talk about is the man with the black umbrella. So this one has been slightly debunked also, but still people don't really believe his story. It's just kind of weird in general, but I'll just get right into it. So as the limo was driving by, there was a mysterious man who was holding like a black umbrella while it was a clear sky kind of day. It wasn't raining or anything like that. So it was just very suspicious. Also just like the look of like the black umbrella and like his outfit and everything just looked very, very odd, if you ask me. I don't know. He was also standing right where the shots were fired from. So obviously that's very, very suspicious. However, this man was actually Louis Stephen Witt, who testified saying that his umbrella was a part of a protest against John F. Kennedy's father's appeasement policies. While some people believe his story, a lot of people also believe that he might have had something to do with the assassination. The next theory is about CIA assassins. The president passed Elm Street while he was being shot, and on the north side of Elm Street there was a car found with three homeless men who the police arrested. So these homeless men are found suspicious because they were dressed very nice and they were very clean shaven, so people are led to believe that possibly these were CIA assassins, which is kind of crazy to think about. I don't really know. It's just kind of weird that like three homeless people would be clean shaven and very nice dressed and like, I don't know. The next theory is probably the most popular one, and it is all about the magic bullet or the one bullet theory. So I kind of realized I hate the way that I explained this theory in this video, and it's kind of like the most important one, so I'm gonna do it over voiceover really quick for you guys and have like diagram pictures and stuff. But basically, Lee Harvey Oswald shot three shots, and we know that. And because of the type of gun he was using and the speed of how quickly the shots were shot, it's only possible that he could have had three shots at the president. So what we know is the first shot missed and didn't hit anybody, and this third shot hit the president's head, which is like the most famous one that you see. But the second shot is where it comes into confusion, because basically in order for this one bullet theory, because there was only three possible shots that day, if Lee Harvey Oswald was acting alone, it basically would have had to go through JFK's back, out his throat, and then hit Connolly in his chest, wrist, and thigh. But if you look at the diagram, it doesn't really make sense considering the fact that they were sitting at level, at the same level. Connolly was sitting right in front of JFK, and in order for the one bullet to hit, it would have to like turn around midair multiple times, which obviously is impossible. So that's where people call it the magic bullet theory. Because it doesn't really, like, it's literally would have to, like, it's just not possible for that to happen. However, it was found that Connolly wasn't sitting directly in front of JFK, and he was sitting slightly to the side, and also he was kind of turned. So if that happened, then the single bullet theory could be true. However, John Connolly, till the day he died, he always said that he believed that there was another bullet and that it was not possible that there was a single bullet. He just didn't think that that was true. So I think that in itself speaks a lot. The person who was actually affected by it didn't believe that he was only shot by one bullet, or like that there was only
three and there was only Lee Harvey Oswald. But also you need to speculate who was behind Lee Harvey Oswald, because he said that he was set up by the government even when he was being arrested for this. He said that he did it, but he said that he was set up by the government. And yeah, so it's pretty interesting to think about. And also it's just kind of weird. So the single bullet theory slash magic bullet theory isn't necessarily 100% true or 100% false. Like, there still could have been two bullets. We just don't know. However, we know that it's not possible if Connolly was actually sitting right in front of Kennedy. But I don't know. Let me know what you guys think on this one. Sorry I explained it so poorly in the video. I filmed this, like, pretty late last night, and I realized I didn't even speak English, like, 98% of the time. So this is a better explanation. And some diagrams.
And the last theory, of course, is the Illuminati. I mean, what fucking conspiracy theory about, like, a celebrity or president would it be without the Illuminati? So it is speculated that the Illuminati could have been behind the shooting of JFK. Possibly the person behind the magic bullet could have been hired by the Illuminati, or even Lee Harvey Oswald could have been hired by the Illuminati. I don't know. I definitely think that there was more than one shooter. I think that makes a lot of sense, but it's the question of who was the other shooter, and it was probably just somebody who was also hired by whoever Lee Harvey Oswald was hired by. So people speculate the Illuminati, other than just because it's the fucking Illuminati, they speculate it because JFK wanted to end the Vietnam War. People believe the Illuminati got angry over JFK's attempts to control the power of the US Federal Reserve, causing the Illuminati to assassinate the president who decided to cross them and try to take control, when they know the real control lies within the fucking Illuminati, of course. Like, who's surprised? Literally nobody. But yes, so those are all the theories that I have for you guys. These are the ones that I find the most interesting. I think the man in the umbrella one is kind of far-fetched. Like, that one's just kind of, but that one's just kind of weird. Like, could be coincidence. I kind of believe the Illuminati one. I don't really know. The Illuminati slash government, like CIA kind of thing. I definitely believe that there was more than one hitman. It just doesn't add up, really. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below. If you guys like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you follow me on Twitter, Snapchat, and Instagram, because I'm always posting dope shit on there. If you want to check out my latest video, you can click right here and click right here to subscribe for new videos every single day, and I will see you all tomorrow. Bye.